This is the 116th show. You know it's the last gig, or at least for the year, and you're kind of wound up a bit about it.
Happy holidays!
I love the feeling of having done this amount of work and you finished it.
My old lady, it's Mick on the phone, and I instinctively know what he's going to say. Do you think it's time to... Yeah, I'm feeling the same way. You know, there's a kind of antsy thing, and I'd have called you next week if you hadn't called me.
What I'm really worried about is the opening, because first things first, so... What's the opening number going to be?
Here we go.
Rehearsing's hard work, but you stop for 10 minutes between each song, which you certainly don't do up there. And so a club's the next one.
Time you were my little rooster, but am I just a one of your clocks? It's worth just to sell ya. You're gonna have to trust me. It's worth just to spend your knowledge.
Every time we said we were going back on the road, then we really need to touch how the hell this band started and where it came from, which is like small clubs.
The old adage is the club show is worth a week of rehearsal because you really know what's going on.
It breaks the band back into stage mode again, you know?
Hey, good.
Small gigs, small gigs.
I love it.
Yeah, that's the
one.
Everything on this tour, everywhere you go, is an adventure.
I'm always very happy with 20 shows, you know. That's when you start to get it perfect.
The difficult thing is doing it well every time. That's the pressure, if you like.
The energy of the crowd overtakes any other thoughts I've got. Anything can happen out there. We can handle it.
Just a teacher and my girl.
1 was played January 15, 1967 at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum. Green Bay defeated Kansas City. Believe it or not, it was a day game because later that evening on CBS, the Rolling Stones appeared on the Ed Sullivan Show. So now we come full circle. Super Bowl 40 will be played in Detroit on February 5th. We'll see it here on ABC. And the halftime entertainment will be provided by the Rolling Stones.
What do you remember most about that night?
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.
40 years ago, it would have been unthinkable that your group would play an event like this. Have the Rolling Stones moved closer to the American mainstream culture, or has the culture moved closer to you?
I think both, really, to be perfectly 50-50. Honest. I think both. I mean, America's obviously changed since we first came here. It's almost unrecognizable, to be perfectly honest. It's very hard to imagine what the United States was like 40 years ago, but it was not like this. And the Super Bowl wasn't like this either. It wasn't such a worldwide event. So, you know, I think we've definitely, you know, we've grown with the American culture changes, and America's changed a great deal. And hopefully, though both of us still have our core values intact.
I knew it was, you know, America's biggest event.
The whole week was a nightmare to look at, including what would happen with the stage.
We have the largest stage that's ever been used for a Super Bowl. It weighs probably about 18 tons. It's moved out in pieces and hooked together. We have 5.5 minutes to do the complete setup. There's lighting in it, there are smoke machines in it. Of course, the band comes out in the dressing room that's actually in the stage. We have 350 volunteers from Detroit who've been working now 3 weeks, taking it apart, putting it together, taking it apart, putting it together.
The trick at this particular venue is the fact that there's only one tunnel for everybody.
When they went down this incline, everyone had to hold them back.
It's high pressure.
No, I've had a walk around it. You know, I mean, yeah, why not? I mean, yeah, it's just a matter of timing, really. It's quite
No, that's the thing. No, it's true. It's a ways.
We're looking to see the liability of falling over on a stage that's going to be put up in 5 minutes. So I said, Mick, we've got to play that old game, you know, on the pavement. You don't step on the cracks.
There's so many things to think about, not just remember the words of Rough Justice.
And then I have to go back and relearn Satisfaction.
If we do it for 12 minutes, we've probably got more advertising time for our logo. Other cats, you know, Mercedes are paying $2.5 million for 30 seconds. This is a coup, you know.
Wondering if, given the debacle from a couple of years ago, whether the NFL is taking an extra interest in what songs you're performing and in what manner and that sort of thing.
Well, you know, the network television is, they're always worried about how many times you're going to say fuck on the air, basically.
It's not a big surprise, the sensitive issue. I just said to them, look, we're just going to sing what we sing and you just have to beep out what you don't want.
Stop me up!
The Russians use these two, but the new wave of censoring is to double up on the right hand. So yeah, it'll probably be something kind of like that.
Stop me up, I never stop. All right, lift the dial and I will blow my time.
It is our intention to protect the family values of the planet Earth.
I tell you, girl, made a grown man cry. And you, girl, made a dead man cry.
All I've got to do is rely on the fact that the guys who can say they can put that stage up in 5.5 minutes flat actually have it up. Give me the stage. I just go out there and play.
Stop me up!
Rolex up.
The National Football League presents the Sprint Super Bowl 40 halftime show.
Here comes the stage.
Stage coming.
20 seconds.
It was very chaotic, wasn't it? Everyone shouting, people with bullhorns.
Just sitting in this black box with the guitars and the amplifiers, we were looking at each other. I mean, I felt like I was inside some Roman battering ram.
Is it going to be assembled in time?
I hope they make it. Everybody's looking at the clock.
15. Stand by 32. Here we go. Coming out in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Don't try, don't try, don't try. I can't get no, I can't get no. Where am I driving? Supposed to mess my imagination. I let God know. And Lola, hey, hey, that's why I